You may have noticed that some journals and granting agencies are now requiring something called an ORCID ID from researchers. What is it and why do you need one? Hi, I'm Karen McKee, and in this video, I'll explain what ORCID is and how to set up an ID. ORCID stands for Open Researcher and Contributor ID. It's a unique, persistent identifier for a researcher composed of a 16-digit number and the profile of the researcher. The ID helps distinguish you from other researchers, especially those with the same or similar names. The ID stays with you for your entire career, even if your name changes through marriage, for example, or you move to a different organization. Here is an online version of a research paper. Click on the author's name and you'll see the ORCID ID number beneath the author name and email address. Click on the link and you'll be taken to the public profile of the researcher on the ORCID platform. This is what an ORCID ID looks like in the PDF version of a paper. If you hover the cursor over the green symbol, you'll see the 16-digit ID number. The ID is also shown at the end of the paper, right before the references. Click on the link and you'll be taken to the researcher's public profile. Setting up an ORCID account is easy and free. Go to orcid.org, click Sign In or Register, and then select Register Now. Fill in your name and email address. Since I'm already registered, I get a warning that I'm already in the system. So I'll put in a different email address. Click Next, and a new screen with a list of researchers with similar name pops up. The first one is mine. The other two are researchers with the name Karen McKee. If you already have an ID, select this button to go back and sign in. If not, select this button to continue with registration. The next screen asks you to create a password. On the next screen, you can set the visibility settings. Normally, you want your profile to be visible to everyone, since the purpose of ORCID is to assist researchers in sharing their information with others. Then check the Terms of Use boxes and I'm not a robot. Click the Register button and you're done. Now you can sign in with either your email or ID number. Enter your password. You'll also be asked for a code that you can get from a third-party authentication app. Enter that code and your ORCID page will open. You'll see your ID number in the top left corner of the screen. Below that will be your email address you use to register. You can add more email addresses as well as websites and social links. You can also add other professional IDs. Click the pin to edit any of these options. In the editing window for all of these options, you can set the visibility of the information. In most cases, you want the information to be public, but you can limit visibility to trusted associates or just yourself. Adding keywords related to your research will help people find you when searching the ORCID registry. You can also list the countries you've done research in or have held a position in. To the right is your professional profile, where you will add information about your employment, education, invited positions, society memberships, funding, and publications. At the top is your name. Here you want to enter the name you wish to display in your ORCID record. You can also add other versions of your name that you may have used in the past. Next is an option to include a biography of up to 5,000 words, but it's probably best to keep this short. As you can see, I've written a very brief summary of my research interests and other activities. Below that are options to add your employment record, your education and other professional qualifications, invited positions and distinctions, membership in professional societies and service, And under funding, you can manually list your research grants. You can also search for grants you've received by using the Add button and selecting Search and Link. The Dimensions Wizard finds grants awarded by NSF and NIH in the United States, as well as funding agencies in the UK and 50 other countries. Just add your name and select Find. As you see, it's found 6 grants from NSF. I'll select all and hit the Next button, then Submit to ORCID. And there they are listed in my profile. The last section is Works, where your publications and other products are listed. You can add new works by clicking the Add button. Here you have the option of adding a publication by hand, by DOI if you know it. If you have a PubMed ID, you can import works from that source. You can also import citations from BibTeX. But the easiest option is to search and link using one of the 17 wizards to find your publications. By linking your ORCID account to one of these wizards, we'll automatically populate your profile with publications listed on these platforms. The two that I've linked to are Crossref and Scopus. Let's look at Crossref. You can search with your name or DOI for a journal article. Here's the DOI for a recent paper just published online, and the citation shows up. It shows that the record is already in my profile. If not, you can add it. Another source to link to is Scopus. Selecting it opens up profiles of people with the name Karen McKee. The third one in the list is me, based on the subject areas and the affiliation. Select Show Recent Documents, and you'll see your most recent pubs. Since my ORCID account is already linked to Scopus and Crossref, any new publications will be automatically added to my record. You are not limited to journal articles in the list of works. You can include data sets, conference presentations, lectures, and other research outputs. For example, I added my TEDx lecture, which has a link to the YouTube video. I've also included several videos about my research, which were posted on my agency's YouTube channel. This one highlighted research on the Mississippi River flood of 2011. The Actions button allows you to combine, export, or delete records, as well as change their visibility. Selecting Export Works opens a box saying that the record is ready to export to BibTeX. When you are done, log out by selecting your name at the top. That takes you back to the sign-in screen. Well, that's a quick overview of ORCID. With an ORCID ID, you can clarify what works are yours and ensure that there is no confusion over your professional identity. It takes only a few minutes to register and fill out the basic information. And as I said earlier, journals are now requiring authors to provide an ORCID ID. Thanks for watching, and please tap the like button if you found this information helpful.